Welcome to Impact OC, the only program showcasing the people and organizations shaping Orange County, with your host, Don Kamber.
Hello, live from the OC Talk Radio studios at UCI's BEALL Applied Innovation Center. I'm OC Talk Radio Public Affairs Director Don Kamber with another great guest impacting our community in a positive way. Today, I welcome Festival of Arts Pageant of the Masters Marketing and Public Relations Director Sharbie Higuchi. Both events return in Laguna Beach after a year's absence due to COVID. The Festival of Arts Fine Arts Show is scheduled July 5th through September 3rd. The Pageant of the Masters will go on July 7th through September 3rd. Sharbie, thank you for being on Impact OC.
Don, I want to say thank you for having me on Impact OC. And we are just so thrilled to be welcoming people back to Laguna Beach to the Festival of Arts and Pageant of the Masters this summer.
Sharbie, please explain what we can expect for the Pageant of the Masters with the theme Made in America, Trailblazing Artists and Their Stories.
Well, first of all, after a year of everything that we've all been through, I think the theme is so apropos with the, and it has a very upbeat, uplifting type of spirit about it. As you said, it's called Made in America, and it's Trailblazing Artists and Their Stories. And so the theme itself is we're going to go behind the scenes and look at the artwork by American artists or artists who moved to America and captured the history, Americans' history, on canvas through sculpture and through their magical works of art. It's going to be a really stunning and uplifting show. Some of the artists that we're going to be featuring is going to be Edward Hopper, Mary Cassatt, Winslow Homer, Edmonia Lewis. There's some really wonderful artwork that really tells a story about American history and what we're all about here in America.
Explain what the pageant is.
Well, that's a tough one, Dawn, as you know, how many years I've been doing this with you over the years. But yeah, so I'm going to try to put it in words. And what we do, it sounds a little crazy, but we actually take live people and we dress them up in costume and makeup to look like famous works of art. We then have these lovely sets that are the size of the artwork that we are recreating, and they pose into the set. And they look just exactly like the painting or the sculpture that we're trying to recreate during our show. It's called Living Pictures or Tableau Vivants. But here's the magical thing about the Pageant of the Masters. Not only do you see this wonderful, incredible artwork put together on stage, it is a production at night, it's also accompanied by some really lovely orchestra music. And then we have our narrator who reads a script live each and every night, and he tells the story about each of these wonderful works of art that is being presented on stage. You know, there's nothing like it anywhere else in the world. And I just have to say, you got to see it to believe it.
How are you able to pull it off this year due to COVID? Because you didn't know if you were going to be able to do it.
Oh my gosh, let me just tell you, this has been an amazing feat by our wonderful Pageant of the Masters staff. And literally, they had to take a year's worth of work and cram it into 3 months in order to get this done. And it's happening. And they have done an amazing job, especially with the ever-changing COVID rules. We had to have rehearsals. Everyone who's actually in the show, they're all volunteers, and they're of all different ages, from age 5 all the way up. So during rehearsals, we had to follow all the proper COVID health and safety guidelines with masks and everything. So it's been a bit of a challenge, but they figure it out, and we're going to have a show beginning July 7th.
And as they make their way to the stage to be in the audience, they're on the Festival of Arts grounds, where there's a lot of art.
Yeah.
Please describe the grounds and the art that we're going to be seeing.
I will. So I have to tell, okay, so there's two shows for the price of one, basically, if you come to the Pageant of the Masters. So right in front of our amphitheater, we have a wonderful fine art show. And this year, we're featuring the artwork of an artist, about 120 artists this year. It's of every medium and style you can imagine. There's jewelry and painting, photography, You name it, we have it. It's a very unique show in that it's all Orange County artists, right? So, and it's a juried show. So to get into the Festival of Arts Fine Art Show, it's a real privilege to be selected to showcase your work at the Festival of Arts. So this is really interesting. The artists who are showcasing their work there, they would have been the artists who would have been in the show in 2020. So we had those artists actually go ahead and be in the show for 2021. And the artwork, as I said, was amazing. Something to do for everyone, something for, you know, and we also have entertainment and music and kids activities and art demonstrations. So there is a lot to do prior to going into the Pageant of the Masters. And one of my favorite things to do, and I suggest to people to do, is talk to the artist about their artwork. It is just fascinating, the story behind their creations and what they do. And check out some of those art demonstrations. So we're excited. And I'm excited for the artist, because you can imagine that was a year worth of not having an income. And a lot of our artists, that's their primary income source, is being able to showcase their work at the festival.
And you offer tours.
We do offer tours. We have daily tours, and that is a great way to find out more about the Festival Arts, the pageant, our history, as well as to go by through each of our festival artist booths and learn a little bit about their background. Why, again, like I was just talking about, creating their art, what was their inspiration? What's your medium? And they're wonderful tours to take, and I would encourage people, if you come down, to take them.
And of course, it's a great way to learn how to appreciate art, which I'm asking right now.
Of course, it's a great way to appreciate art, because you hear it firsthand in many cases from the artist. And everybody, you know, appreciates art a little differently. And there, as I said before, there are different styles. We have very contemporary, we have the traditional, we have the abstract. And hopefully, as people talk to the artist, they will learn a little bit more about the inspiration behind the artwork, how they constructed the artwork, which is always fascinating to me, a lot more complicated than you might think many, many times. And the details and the research that goes behind them. But it could be, you know, where they're from and their home life that might inspire them. It could be trips. It could be you know, other locations. But it's definitely great, as I said, to talk to the artist, enjoy the artwork, and just maybe take something home.
And there's different mediums. I mean, we're not just talking paintings. No. We're talking jewelry. We're talking sculpture.
You're right. You're talking everything. You name it, we have it. Photography, jewelry, painting, sculpture, mixed media. It's there, and it's all in different styles, and they're diverse as the artists who've made them. So I encourage them. It's fun. It's fun to walk through and take a look at all the art.
And you will have music on the grounds.
Yes, we do have music on selected nights and on weekends during the day. That's always a lot of fun. On Thursday nights, we're going to have art, jazz, wine, and chocolate. So wine and chocolate pairings with some wonderful jazz music. That starts at 5:30. There's a little additional fee for that, for to enjoy the wine and chocolate. And Saturday afternoons, concerts on the greens. Some fun performances there. And we're also going to try and tribute bands this year. So that's going to be really fun. So I'll tell you the days to go is Friday, Saturday, and Sundays to check out the music. And here's a tip. If you are going to the Pageant of the Masters and you have your ticket, that is a season pass to the Festival of Arts. So you can come back all summer long to the Festival of Arts in Laguna Beach and enjoy all the music that's going on. So I say, make it your summertime destination. Come back again, enjoy the music, enjoy the art demonstrations.
Let's talk about food and water. What's allowed?
Well, you know what? You know, things are ever changing right now. So we should have our restaurants open and running. We have two on-site restaurants. One is Terra. It's more of a fine dining type of experience. And then another kind of, I will say, grab and go type of food experience, which is with intermission. However, if you feel like you want to bring your own picnic in, and your own bottle of wine, you are welcome to do that. There are some regulations that before you come in, just make sure you go on our website so you have the proper, you're allowed one bag and it has to fit under the chair, and there's some different rules and regulations, but easy to follow. It's a lot of fun to sit on the green, listen to the music, and have your picnic. And everything, we have reserved tables as well. So if you just want to make sure you are guaranteed a table to listen to the music, I suggest going on our website and buying a reserve seat.
The website is?
It is very easy, festivalarts.com or festivalarts.org.
And what are the COVID protocols?
Well, you know, Donna, this is ever changing, and it's been, and right now it looks like everything's going to be well opened up, and there's not going to be any capacity limits on the festival or the pageant. There is a possibility of mask encouragement, but and additionally, we will have like hand sanitizers throughout the grounds to make it really easy for people. But I promise you, we will be in compliance with whatever government safety and guidelines are out there. We've been working very closely with the city of Laguna Beach to make sure we are in compliance.
Can they buy tickets on site?
You can buy, I would suggest buying your Pageant the Masters tickets in advance at pageanttickets.com because those tickets go very quickly, especially on certain nights. Here's a tip, everybody, go on a Monday or Tuesday, you'll get some great seats. And so buy those online in advance. Now the art show tickets, you can buy those the day of. So just walk up to our box office and purchase a ticket to the art show.
Tell us about the volunteers that participate in the pageant.
Okay, now our volunteers, this is what, you know, first let me just say, the Festival Arts and Pageant is a nonprofit art organization, and a lot of people don't realize that. So, and our mission is to support the arts and arts education. And the one and only reason that we can put on this amazing living picture show called The Pageant of the Masters is because of 500 volunteers. It is a huge community event. It takes 500 volunteers to put on the show. So the people that you see posing up on stage as these famous works of art, they're all volunteers. Our youngest volunteer is 5 years old, and our eldest volunteer, well, they probably want me to tell you, but they're about 80 plus. And so we also have volunteers that are not only just in the show, but they're behind the scenes. They help us get people prepared in their costumes. They apply makeup. We actually teach people to how to apply makeup. And it's really quite remarkable. And we have history of just generations of families that make it an annual event to be in the Pageant of the Masters. So we have great-great-grandparents that have been in it many years ago, and now their great-grandchildren, who are now 5 years old, are in the Pageant of the Masters.
Logistics to get there.
Well, that sometimes can be tricky if everybody knows Laguna Beach. You know, we do sometimes have some issues with parking and or just traffic. So a couple suggestions. So we have a lot that's as you come down Laguna Canyon Road that's called Act 5. It's a little far, a little distance just from the Festival Arts, but you can park in the Act 5 parking lot or lot 16 through the city of Laguna Beach. And then we have this incredible trolley, free trolley system that you can then jump on the trolley and it'll come then take you right into Laguna Beach. And there's a stop right at the Festival Arts and Pageant of the Masters. So jump off that trolley and enjoy the art show.
And when you see the Pageant of the Art, the Pageant of the Masters, you're seeing sculptures, which means people have the body paint on to look like a sculpture. Explain that.
Okay, yes. So when you see those incredible sculptures of people, those are live people. And basically the only thing they really have on right there is makeup. So if there's some, and we have been known to have some nude statues in our show. And so the volunteers who are nude, they are nude with the exception of a little privacy patch right in the very front, and makeup. So, and that's about it. And sometimes it's kind of funny to be sitting in the audience and watching people with their binoculars at that time, but you know, but they are. And this is interesting. So since its inception, because, you know, there has been nudity in art throughout history since its inception, the pageant, since back in 1933, we have had nudes in the show. So it is done very obviously, we're reproducing this wonderful art and paying tribute to it. So it's very respectful.
And you could tell us how it ends, because it ends the same every year, but the painting changes.
Yeah, so our traditional finale since 1936 has been Leonardo da Vinci's The Last Supper. And I will tell you, yes, people, spoiler alert, it will be in the show this year. And I will tell you, sometimes people get very upset when it's not, but it is absolutely in the show this year now, which is kind of a challenge. If you think of what I told you, the theme was made in America and focusing on American artists. You're wondering, how is she going to do that? Our director has a surprise for our audience, and it has to do with an LA photographer by the name of Matthew Rolston, who actually came down to the Festival Arts and Pageant Masters a few years back and did a beautiful portrait series of our pageant volunteers in costume and makeup during the show. And I'm going to plug the Laguna Art Museum right now, because there's a lot of synergy going on here. But over at the Laguna Art Museum during the summer, they're going to have his photographs on display. And so there's a beautiful tie-in with the Laguna Art Museum having on display his incredible artwork and photography. And then in the pageant, we are going to introduce The Last Supper through these wonderful portraits of our pageant volunteers who are in The Last Supper.
And I want to point out, when people are in the Pageant of the Masters and they're in the show, they have to remain still. For how long?
Okay, now that's a tricky thing. Yes, they have to hold their poses for roughly about 90 seconds. So think about those little five-year-olds that might have the jitters a little bit. It can be a little bit challenging. However, it does make it fun for the audience when they do see a little bit of movement. And our director, Diane Chalice-Davy, she actually has brought more movement into the show since she's been director. Actually, she's celebrating her 25th year as pageant director this year. So she's brought more movement. There's a piece called The Builder that we actually show the audience how we put a living picture together from start to finish. And it always has the wow factor. It's always the wow factor in the show for sure.
So to be comfortable, what should people bring? What should they wear to be comfortable? Because they are outdoors under the stars and it is late at night.
Yes, it's a beautiful amphitheater under the stars, as you said. And what a lot of people will mistakenly think about is, hey, I'm going to the beach. It's going to be hot and beautiful. Not so in the canyon. It's a little chilly. So I would recommend either bringing a blanket or a sweater or a jacket, just in case it gets a little chilly. We do have some options. We do have a nice gift shop that you can purchase some blankets or sweaters or sweatshirts from that as well, in case you do forget it. But I do recommend that.
Tell us some of the reactions that you've gotten for the Pageant of the Masters from people who do not live in Orange County and it's so foreign to them.
All right, Don, you know you've been to the pageant. It's always fun to bring someone who's been for the first time, because the first couple of paintings that come out or pictures come out, you know, you can't. It looks just like a painting. You think you're in a museum, and that is an actual painting or picture. And then the minute that there's some movement, their mouth just drop open. They're like, are you kidding me? Those are people in there. It is. It's like I said, it's like one of those things you have to see to believe. It's amazing. The artists that actually work on building the pageant and the sets, they are so excellent at their craft and what they do to really make it look like the real thing, like a painting or a sculpture, and, you know, or even a poster. Sometimes we've actually reproduced posters.
Thank you, Festival of Arts, Pageant of the Masters, Marketing and Public Relations Director Sharbie Higuchi, for being on Impact OC. And I thank everyone for tuning in. I'm OC Talk Radio Public Affairs Director Dawn Kamber. Have an impactful day.
You've been listening to Impact OC, the only program showcasing the people and organizations shaping our community. Right here on Orange County's only community radio station, OC Talk Radio.